Hey, what's going on, guys? Heads here from Infinity Loops, and today we take a look at my week spent with the T20 by Jumper. Look at that, we can just take our gimbal right out. Now, before we get into some footage from the week spent with this radio, let's first just kind of have a glance at what we get in the box here. We have the T20 that we're looking at, which is kind of a dark blue color. It's a very dark blue color. It's borderline black, but you can kind of tell the difference in the back here with the grips that it is not black, it is blue. This is a box style radio, if you couldn't tell, and that is a first for me. I've never used a box style radio for a long period of time. I've borrowed them and used them for a flight or two, but I've never committed to using one for a long period of time, so that should be interesting. Something else new for me would be the full-sized gimbals that we have on here. I have the Hall gimbals on mine, which I believe are the only ones that come on the T20. The T20S is available with the RDC90 gimbals on that one. The radio is running Express LRS, which is capable of up to 1 watt. And you have a omnidirectional foldable antenna here on the top, which is not actually pictured on the box. It shows like one of the little cheap antennas on the box, but it comes with this very nice collapsible, foldable, whatever you want to call it, omnidirectional antenna for your Express LRS. Moving down from the antenna, we have our screen, which is a 1.3 inch OLED screen, which is going to be showing you Edge TX on it, because that is what comes on the radio. We also have 6 programmable buttons, which we are not going to be using, and we have a CNC metal scroll wheel here, which is very clicky and very responsive. I like it a lot, actually. It's very nice for navigating through the menu. This radio has the classic Jumper switches that I'm used to seeing on the T-Lite. So if you've ever used the T-Lite, it has the same switches there, which are the bi-directional on the bottom, and you have your 3-ways on the top. Moving to the backside real quickly, this has a huge radiator on it, which is going to be for relieving some heat off of the Express LRS in here. You also have a port underneath here, which has an XT30 plug if you're going to be using an external module, and you have a battery bay here that can fit up to 21700 batteries, but we're only going to be using 18650s in here with the sled that was provided that came with it. Also, I should mention, because I usually gripe about it with other radios, this has but one USB-C port on the top, and that is to do your charging, your updating, your simming, everything, all through one port. How convenient. Almost as convenient as that lawnmower right now. Okay, that is enough about the radio, and I am getting drowned out by the lawnmower a little bit. So let's move on to my week spent with the Jumper T20, and then I got a little surprise for you at the end of the video. We'll go over my thoughts after the week I spent with it. We'll look at a little bit of sim footage from one of the live streams when I used it. We'll also look at some footage of just flying around in here with my whoops, flying around up front with some review quads, just my whole week of using this radio. So let's have a peek, and then we will chat about it afterwards.
We'll do a little comparison here to what I'm used to flying. There's quite a big difference in like the shape and the distance in the gimbals and the size of the gimbals.
Can I have it?
We'll be right back.
What? I thought my my stick end was coming loose, like the, you know, your stick end. No.
Don't tell me it's broken.
Look at that, we can just take our gimbal right out.
Is an idiot that Bardwell pooped out.
The whole stick.
Backup mode activated.
That was fast. Welcome back. Now that I've spent the lawnmower's back too. Good timing. Now that I've spent a week with it, let's talk a little bit about the T20 and my thoughts on it. First on the list for feedback on this radio is I do not like box radios. I tried, but I just can't get used to it. I think as a thumber, number one, and number two, I'm just so used to gamepad style radios at this point. It's been a big part of my life even before RC, so I'm just kind of, my hands are just kind of used to holding a gamepad radio. So box radio is not for me, is what it is. Moving on to the gimbals, even though they are full size and it gives me a lot of resolution for when I'm flying, I didn't really find it very good for me as far as like with the fast proximity whoop stuff I like to do. I just couldn't get used to the full size throw of the gimbals. So I'm used to, for instance, one of the issues I was running into was coming out of power loops or a dive. I wouldn't be giving it enough throttle and I would tap the ground and kind of have to overcorrect because I was undershooting my throttle thinking I was giving it enough because of how much my thumb is used to moving, but I actually wasn't because I need to give it just a little bit more on these gimbals. And that was something that took me a while. I mean, it was every time I picked up the radio this week, every day, I had to get used to that for the first pack or two. It would happen. I would tap out on the ground a couple times. But if you like full-size gimbals, this would be perfect for you. While we're still talking about the gimbals, I wanted to mention that that was the only issue that I really had or found with this radio. And I'm assuming it's probably just me because I haven't heard anybody else complaining about it yet. But I had my throttle yaw gimbal was so loose. I guess the knurling that was down on the inside of the stick is not holding very well. And I went to go take the stick end off and I couldn't get it to break loose. Took off the roll pitch stick end just fine. That came off nice and easy. But I couldn't get this one to break loose off of the threads and it kind of felt like there was a little bit of resistance to it. And it was because the whole stick was spinning inside of the plastic down here at the bottom. So I was able to get it out eventually and I will just fix that with a little bit of glue. It's not really that big of a deal, but it is something that happened while I was using it. Actually, you probably saw some footage of that happening live. I did only end up using the one switch in Quicksilver, just the two-way switch there, and that was just arm disarm is all I really need anymore with that. So I didn't test out any of the other switches, but I imagine they switch just as well as most switches would. The ELRS performance on the radio, as far as I could tell, I flew to the end of my neighborhood a few times and back and over to the park from my house, and the distance on it is really good. It's just about as good as any other external module that I've used. I didn't really push it to the limit, so we're not going to say that it is that good, but as far as I was pushing it with micros, it had been plenty. Now, with all of that being said, I would love to give this to one of you because I don't think I'm gonna get any use out of it. And I would hate to see this just sit around and not get used. So let's just do something simple, like leave a comment down below, whatever you'd like, say whatever you want. You can tell me if you had any thoughts about the radio or if you had been wanting to get one yourself. I'll make sure to fix that gimbal up for you before I send it to you.
But otherwise, I'll pack it up and ship it out to whoever we choose, let's say in a week from when this video is posted, about 7 days there, we'll pick a commenter down below and you get a nice T20 radio. Oopsies, hi, editing me here, just now realizing that the last little bit of that file was corrupted and I don't have an outro or the part where I say that you can find a link for that radio down below if you're interested in getting one, and that it's not an affiliate link. But now that I've said that, thank you so much for watching, and we will see you in the next one. Check this out.
Schnaps.
Oh, inverted, y'all. Schnap. You like it? Bang. Ooh.